swim pool, right? Okay. During these high
speeds.
So let's
go to the inside now. Like I said, I'll give you all the link for it as well. Let's see.
This is an amazing environment for these to be in, and this is a great representation of those details. All right, so come join me inside here.
Now, there's one, I won't say mistake, but one thing that NASCAR doesn't have, they obviously changed that, is a door. That's not supposed to open. They do it at the auto show cars, too. But anyway, yeah. And I'm surprised.
Because this is the business department inside.
Look how easily Tony gets in there. I think the Challenger was just as easy to get in. I'm not sure, but I know, like I said, my car, I guess being a, I don't know why, but being a race car going down the quarter mile, that cage within there, so I have in mind, is harder to get in.
All right.
I thought I'd be adding more. But
all right, so come on in here and let's see how we get this done. It's a quick release wheel. Makes it easy to get in and out.
Yeah, look, he fits in there pretty comfortably.
And now we are in the business department. The business department. Every place has a business department, whether it's a building or a car. This is where business is done. All right? There is so much done in here, detail-wise.
I'd be the same way.
First off, you can take somebody with you. Second, you can see that the chassis, right? The chassis is welded all around the whole car, and then the car is actually hung on top of the chassis, right? The chassis doesn't really need the body of the car other than to make for aerodynamics because everything is so stiff and welded together. It's really amazing. Air conditioning controls there. If you decide you want to use the air conditioning, your shift light right here, power cutoff switch, full array of gauges in your face, right, so you can see things. The only thing that you may consider changing is this says 160 mile an hour speedometer, and if this car goes significantly faster than that, you might want to think about that. However, 160 is probably pretty fast, and you might want to experiment with that first. This has the
if I pay for it, I'm going to use all of it. It certainly says that.
Transmission cooler, fans, and then you got a start button right here. These are actually power windows, right? These are power windows for this car, which is kind of cool. So a track day, you could take this car, enjoy it, and drive it on home, which is super amazing. Full sets of the seat belts. You got shoulder and lap. And you're in a cockpit, man. This is it. You're doing your business. You're driving.
Looks just like
your
NASCAR. Yeah, sure does. Right, big as those gauges
so many
are.
So little things that you can't really see. I don't know if in the video or not, but so many little touches that you can't really see. The fasteners being stainless steel. The VIN number welded to the top of the tag, to the top of the dash, so you can make sure, you know, you're in compliance. Clips to hold the windshield in place because of the turbulence that's inside the car, right? Trying to keep the driver cool during those high-speed races. And beautiful tin work done in the back.
I wonder how stiff that clutch is.
Such a well-put-together car. I could ramble on for days about this. I don't want to bore you, but and you drive it, you'll know exactly why I'm smiling. All right, so we're going to close up the video, but I want to read a couple small things to you just so you know what you're getting, right? You're not getting just a 69 Torino with a motor in it, right? You're getting a full NASCAR chassis under here, right?
And for those of you who have subscribed to me, you already know, my man Cletus McFarlane, he has the NASCAR truck, which he calls the Dale truck because it's set up like Earnhardt and all that. So that is street legal as well. So this is another older rendition of something like that, basically.
Dale Jarrett's car. The hood from Holman & Moody car, number 17, okay? The fenders, rear panels, and bumpers are from various cars driven by Richard Petty during the same amount of time. These are expensive
pieces,
right?
Look at the tires.
This is a vintage race car now. Did you hear that? You can go vintage racing in this car. You probably never even thought about that, right? Can you imagine a Saturday or Sunday in this
car, going around
your local track, a road course or oval or circle, whatever in this car and the sound that it makes, helmet on,
oh my gosh,
shifting through the gears,
working it around the
corners. I mean, it is an experience that is
pay
hundreds of thousands of dollars to enjoy, hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars to enjoy. These cost millions and millions of dollars to build today. So you can imagine what this will be worth even more years down the road. It is a cool, cool piece of history. Anyway, call us, 301-816-1000. We'll tell you all about this 69 Torino.
All right, let's do this. Where's my... Let's turn the volume up and hear what this son of a gun sounds like here. We'll turn it up to 17, and gentlemen, start your engines. I don't know if it's a cold start or not. I don't think it is.
Talladega, all right? And if you would please share the videos with your friends. I hope they like
them.
I'm
doing it.
You hit the like button down below, and if you subscribe to the channel, we got new stuff coming out every single day. And then I will see you on the test drive.
Well, we did drive it. You can't even hear. Didn't drive at home for a couple days. There's no way he did that. I just texted and asked him. I don't think he would have, though. I don't think that'd be too comfortable for him. Now, something. I don't think they did it. Let's see. Nope. Now, something I hate about what the person edited that video is, first thing is that I really hate, we didn't get an idling shot of it. That's what I was waiting for. So we don't know what it sounds like idling. The second thing is, as you can see there, the audio isn't quite, because you see where he was shifting, we didn't really hear anything. So, only two complaints I got about that. Other than that, that car is beautiful. Maybe I don't know. I'll have to ask somebody, maybe just to start up so I can hear it or something. I would love to hear what that thing sounds like. That's what I was waiting to hear. But all we heard was pretty much that thing at the same RPM the whole time. So, which is why sometimes when I'm there, that's why I make my video so y'all can see. But anyways, that is a beautiful, beautiful car, Tony. Oh my gosh, I don't know how long you stayed on that test drive for that thing, because that thing is awesome. I don't think it gave you a headache, did it? And you ain't got to worry about Cam 2 getting in your face, because you didn't have Cam 2 in it, so it just had pump gas. I'm not sure how rich the fuel mixture is and all that. So anyways, but that's a great, great car, man. I like it. I wish I was able to drive, but I know good and well I probably wouldn't be able to, because since it's just in the showroom, that likely won't happen. And it, sad to say this too, it probably won't even be started up that often. So I don't know if he's going to keep it at the back of the showroom. Probably not. Maybe near the front left when you're front right when you go in. But yeah, that car is a beast. It's a beast, and I believe he didn't mention it, but I'm pretty sure he must have it at working off thing running well. The only thing you probably don't have is turn signals, but how many people actually use it? Sadly to say that, how many people actually use turn signals today? So, with that being said, it's a beautiful car, Tony. I love it, man. I wish I worked there so I could drive that thing. Now, this car, like I said, being a NASCAR, it's a stick shift car. Which means it's highly unlikely somebody could steal it, because, first of all, they don't even know how to start it. And hardly anybody these days knows how to drive stick shift. So, that's another good thing about it, and I don't know how many people there know how to drive stick shift either. But, other than that, man, that's a beautiful piece, dude. I'm glad you got it. I don't know what condition it was in when it got there, but whatever you did, it looks great. I'm pretty sure it wasn't that far off when it got there. I know it probably just needed, you know, like I said, your little checklist thing. And a couple of coats of wax and maybe some touch-up paint or something like that. But whatever it was, it worked out well. I don't know what the price is, but I guarantee you it's more than what this Challenger has, though, or what it was. I think that Challenger was like $69,000. I can't remember how much that thing was. But anyway, it's a good video, man. Good build. I love it, man. I wish you the best, and I hope that thing does stay there a while. Either way, man, it's a beautiful car, and obviously, as you can see in the video, you can't even hear yourself talking, so that's why they had those videos, so you can get back to the crew people and all that, so you can hear them. So, anyway, that's my wrap-up on the build they got there, and love it, man. Miss you guys, and glad you got it, Tony, and, you know, we'll just catch y'all in the next video. I just wanted to point that out. I caught up in my recommended videos list and I almost watched all of it. And so let me cut it off and watch it with you guys so you all can see my reaction to it as well. The paint suspension and all that. It's basically, like I said, a working. You can take that NASCAR off of the track and bring it to the street. However, the difference with this car is it's set up to do all that. When you take a NASCAR car off of the track, it's set up to only turn left. Hence, like, when you take off with one of those, when you let go of the steering wheel, it automatically steers to the left. This car doesn't do that because it's been overhauled suspension-wise, so it doesn't do that. So that's another thing to keep in mind, too. So it has been some suspension work done, as you all clearly saw in the video. But like you said, there's plenty of more stuff I would like to know. I mean, it might be up on a page. If I see that, I'll put it in the description as well. Right now, I'm pretty sure he just finished making a video of it, so I don't even know if that's even up there yet. But, so, anyway, it's a great car. Great what that thing said. I don't know how many pages that the description is going to be from this car. So, that's going to be interesting. But anyway, whoever gets it, enjoy it, man. And please drive the car and do what I told you to do. What I recommend you should do, anyway. So, anyway, that's it for this video. Check you guys in another one. Awesome build, you guys.
Like those cars, my thoughts roll over and over and over in my mind. Tonight I'm in Talladega, boys raised up, a whiskey in one glass. My hair's to turn it up, slowing down, and cars that go real fast. We were laughing and living, drinking and wishing, and thinking as that checkered flag was waving. I sure would like to stay in Talladega.